Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I want to talk to you about percent proportions. You can also solve percent problems with a percent equation. Feel free to go onto YouTube, find a video about that. I'm going to use percent proportions for our class. A proportion is solved like other proportions when it has percent in it, but because we're working with a percentage, we have a 100 in the problem. Typically, we use the terms amount and base equals percent over 100. Sometimes you'll see amount over base equals rate over 100, percent and rate being interchangeable. Sometimes you'll see those abbreviated like A over B equals P over 100, standing for amount, base, and percent. Or that could be an R if they're talking about rate. Another thing that you might see is that you'll see this little helpful proportion is of equals percent over 100. The word is associated with the amount, and the word of is associated with the base in certain types of problems, so this can be helpful. Now remember that when you're using this proportion with 100 on the bottom, you don't move the decimal point because dividing by 100 would already be changing that decimal point. We say there are three types of percent problems because you could be missing the amount or the base or the percent. So any one of those could be missing, which gives us three types of problems. In these examples, round to the hundredths if necessary as you solve these proportions. I always would suggest you try them on your own, then watch my explanation. The first I'm going to do, 36 is what percent of 225? Remember, we're always missing something, and in this case, they're asking what percent, so what's the percent that we're missing? That means when I set this proportion up, my P is going to be the variable because I don't know the percentage. The other two things, I'm going to use these little helpful thing with the word is helps you find the amount, and the word of helps you find the base. That's the is of up here. Since they said 36 is my amount, that goes on top. Of 225, that goes on the bottom. I want to tell you that the greater number does not always go on the bottom. Sometimes it's on the top. That's why you really have to read carefully and make sure you set this up correctly. Once you set the proportion up, you solve it the same way you've solved other proportions. That is, cross-multiply the means, 225 times P, and the extremes, 36 times 100, that's 3600. Once you have those means equal to the extremes, you divide by the coefficient. The coefficient is the number multiplying the variable. In this problem, 225 is our coefficient, so we divide both sides by 225. 225 divided by itself becomes 1, which makes that just P, and then 3600 divided by 225 is 16. We didn't need to round it there. It came out to be exactly 16, and because we're looking for percent, I'm going to go ahead and add that percent symbol. In the second example and third examples, we have the percentage given in both of these. So we're looking for something else. So in this one says, what number is 22.5% of 150? Well, the is helps us identify the amount, and that is what number. We don't know the amount in that problem, so that's our A. I'm using the variables that go along with amount, base, and percent. You can use whatever variables you want. And then of is our 150, that's our base. And then 22.5, I'm not changing that, I'm just putting exactly 22.5 into the problem over 100. The 100 is always a given. If I cross multiply the means, 150 times 22.5, excuse me, that's 3,375, and A times 100 is 100A. The coefficient in this case is 100. That's the number that's multiplying our variable. So we divide both sides by 100 and find out that A is 33.75. That is to the hundredths. I don't need to round that. In my third example, 160 is 130% of what number? The percent is easy to find. That's the 130, and that goes over 100, exactly as it's given. 160 is associated with amount, so 160 is the amount. What number, we don't know, that's the base. So in this case, we're missing the base. If I multiply 130 times B and 160 times 100, I get my equation. And now I'm going to divide both sides of that equation by 130 because that's the coefficient in this problem. Dividing both sides by 130, I get B equals this number. And I think it even maybe went on further, but I don't care how far it goes. I was asked to round to the hundreds. I'm really only interested in the third place. Then I can round back to the second place. And that's how I get the base is about 123.08. In the next video, we'll do some word problems that use percents. Have a great day.